Hey everyone, welcome back to the news. Mike Schultz with you once again, taking a look at the weather. And we were talking about the big storm. And it looks like I said, most of the energy is moving to the south of us. So we're still not going to get out of the woods yet. Things can change, so we got to keep an eye out to the sky and make sure that you give yourself plenty of time to get to your next destination. Numbers look like this. The normal high right around 13 above, the normal low 4 below, record high 49, 1997. What a warm day that was. In contrast, 42 below in 1989, sunrise and sunset. About 6 hours and 54 minutes of daylight, a loss of 7 minutes from yesterday. And once again, a reminder, winter storm warning in effect till 6 o'clock tomorrow night. The rain and snow is still expected this evening, but not as widespread. Tomorrow, heaviest snow will be from Eielson Air Force Base southward and on down to Delta Junction. Snow will diminish by evening, but not until it's dropped close to 8 or 10 inches of snow down there. Okay, what's going on the satellite picture? Again, you can see all the energy moving really rapidly across the state, being driven by the jet stream. And like I said, there is a lot of activity around the Fairbanks area, but more moving to the south. And that's why they're expecting heavy rain tonight in Anchorage, of all places. How about that? We'll talk about that in a little bit. What's going on across the rest of the state? Well, it's not too bad across southeast Alaska, partly cloudy to cloudy skies there, and clear skies around Juneau. Cloudy skies across the Gulf of Alaska. Of course, all the weather going on across the southwest part. Up at Barrow, things are looking pretty good. Clear skies for the most part. In Fort Yukon, 12 degrees and partly cloudy skies. The lower 48 tonight, again, very quiet weather over the western half of the country. In fact, most of the country is looking pretty good. No major storms to talk about. On the satellite and radar, you can see what we're talking about. A little bit of activity moving across the Great Lakes and across the deep south. And then a new system moving across the Pacific Northwest, bringing some showers over the Seattle area, but nothing really heavy expected. Well, back to our jet stream, because that's the main driving force. As you can see, it's going to bring in a lot of cold air over the eastern half of the country and could dive as far south as Atlanta, Georgia by Tuesday night, giving them some possible snow of all things. And again, nice weather over the western half of the country. Well, back to Alaska for tomorrow. Here's what the northern sections look like. Snow showers for Barrow, 1 to 3 inches of snow expected in Nome, and a little light snow at Fort Yukon. Here in the interior, as I said before, it looks like heavier snow will be towards Healy and Delta Junction, with lighter amounts in the Fairbanks area. While over southeast Alaska, it looks like sunshine returns to Ketchikan, while mostly cloudy skies will remain in the Juneau area. And over the southwest part of the state, we're looking at rain and snow at Cold Bay, snow showers in Bethel, and rain for Kodiak Island. And if you head on down the Anchorage area, take that umbrella, because we're looking at heavy rain for Anchorage and Valdez, with rain and snow showers in the Homer area. Okay, here's our forecast for the remainder of the night. Again, we're looking at the periods of snow and rain, 1 to 3 inches possible in the higher elevations is where the heavier snow will be. 20 degrees for the overnight low. Tomorrow, 28 degrees, a little warmer, and cloudy with another possible 1 to 3 inches of snow by the evening hours. In the extended forecast, again, looking at some snow possible on Veterans Day, then partly cloudy on Tuesday, and then another storm system moving in for Wednesday and Thursday. That will continue into Friday. And you see temperatures once again rising way above normal for this time of year. Overnight lows only about 10 degrees, but they should be like 4 degrees below zero. And again, maybe some more snow for the skiers, so they'll be excited about that. But like I said earlier, we dodged a bullet.